I noticed that in my relationships, I have a tendency to make people crumble into like dust. It's like really pathetic to watch. I say my relationships because I don't give my friendships and like my family relationships enough energy. Like if you're just being ignorant, I'll just let you be ignorant and block you. But you know, the dick do something a little different to you and make you want to try to help a nigga. Make you think you got superpowers and shit and can change a nigga. You cannot. But I used to think for a long time, and that affected my self-esteem as well, like that it was me. Like that it was my fault. I'm like, oh my God, what am I doing to these niggas? This is crazy. Every single time. But you know, then one of my spiritual guys came to me, and I will never forget, told me to stop working with people who are made of glass if you are made of steel. And that shit hit me. I was like, oh, I've been searching for this answer for hella long. Like, why would I think I'm crumbling people who were never strong in the first place? They're fragile. Their egos are fragile. They're not quite ready to face themselves, maybe now or ever, so they crumble. The slightest rough patch that hits in life, and then you gotta boss up and be strong and do what you gotta do, crumble. And then, you know, most people don't like to think. I'm a thinker. So now I done walked my ass up in here with this introspection, and it's like I'm a mirror and I'm making you see yourself. And I'm presenting your strengths, your weaknesses, who you are deep inside, not who you portray to be. Your priorities, what you value the most, what needs to be worked on and how we can work on it. Solutions. Dun, dun, dun. Niggas are scared of solutions. But, because we gotta have balance, you know? Niggas be like, whoa, 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 bitch, I wasn't ready to do all that. And I guess they thought because I had face tats, and usually niggas meet me in a real ratchet ass environment, doing some ratchet ass shit. I might have fucked you on the first night. We might have had been smoking and drinking and carrying on and doing whatever else. But at the end of all that ghetto shit, we're going to evolve mentally, spiritually, physically, financially, emotionally. And we are going to have balance. Because that is the only way to maintain longevity and a healthy relationship. Can't stay stagnant for too long. And what always ends up happening is I get the same answer literally every time. Bitch, you think you perfect? And I just keep working on myself and keep evolving. And, you know, one monkey don't stop the show. So I end up doing everything that I was trying to get them to do for myself. And every time I come out of a relationship, I come out smarter. Yeah. I come out healthier, yeah. Happier, yeah. Richer, yeah. Finer, yeah. Thicker. Yeah. you know, shit that I was doing in the beginning of the relationship that was toxic will come to a complete halt, and I just be going up, up, and up. Up, up, and away. Away from that bullshit.